focus. The young man went away grieving, for he had many possessions. A financial meltdown usually leaves people with doubts and fears, making them question the basis of their faith and of following Christ, including whether blessings and money are linked at all. Here are some key questions that occur to me. Is having money a sign of worth, spiritual maturity, or the Lord's approval? Could making do with less in our lives make room for other blessings? Most of the time, we are blessed by the Lord in abundance, but because we keep sharing at the few missing pieces in our lives, we fail to appreciate His free gifts of wealth and health that we enjoy. We complain when things don't go our way, perhaps because we cannot perceive the hidden blessings even in the unwelcome situations we encounter. More questions. The Israelites lusted after other gods. Have money and possessions become other gods for us today? Do we prefer material things to God and forget the total dependence on Him recommended by Jesus in "Give us this day our daily bread"? In today's gospel, Jesus asked the young man to give up his possession. Wasn't it like saying, "You shall have no other gods before me"? Fruit. To which false gods am I attached? Let me not grieve, but give them away to others and be a blessing to them today.